Hello and good day, everyone. I'm Dr. Nigdaliana from University of Malaya, Malaysia. Allow me to present on behalf of my research team members, Dr. Ravza and also Ms. Anis. The topic of our presentation is personality traits and social demographic characteristics associated with active transportation among Malaysians. Active transportation, or ATE, has been shown to be an effective approach to improve overall physical activity by increasing daily physical activity through walking and cycling for more than 10 minutes and use of public transport have been shown to lower cardiometabolic risks such as overweight and obesity, diabetes, metabolic syndrome, and all-cause mortality. Despite the potential health benefits of ATE, it is estimated that about one-third of the global population is physically inactive. In Malaysia, the rate of physical inactivity and the deaths attributed to it is higher than the global average. The latest population health survey reported that 25% of Malaysians are physically inactive, and physical inactivity is responsible for 16% of our country's mortality. Ecological models state that health behaviors such as ATE are influenced by individual factors. In view of the lack of published information on ATE in Malaysia, this study aims to report on active transportation of Malaysian adults to examine its relationship with personality traits and social demographic factors. This is an ongoing project of which we started collecting data in July 2020 during the Recovery Movement Control Order and an Enhanced Movement Control Order in certain areas in Malaysia. The study used an online survey of which data were collected through Google Forms. In the study, we included participants who are Malaysian, aged at least 18 years old, and has access to the internet. The participants were asked to complete a self-administered questionnaire that assessed ATE, socio-demographic factors, and also personality traits. Individuals who reported walking, cycling, or used public transport to work, college, or errands were considered as active, while the others were considered as passive. The personality traits of respondents were determined using the Big Five Personality Inventory, or BFI-10. All the questions used in this study have been validated in our Malaysian setting. The results of this study were derived from preliminary analysis using frequency distribution tables and the chi-square test. A p-value of less than 0.05 was deemed statistically significant. A total of 282 adults have responded to the survey. In terms of demographics, majority of the respondents in our study were female, aged 18 to 59 years old. Many were of Malay ethnicity and married. About 32% of the respondents received tertiary education and mostly have full-time employment and with income less than USD 713. We found that the prevalence of active transportation was 70%, of which males and females contributed 50% respectively. Among those who practiced ATE, more than 80% had emotional stability, characterized as being calm, even-tempered, and secure. As for other personality traits, more than 50% of those practiced ATE reported high scores for each trait. The chi-square test showed significant association between age, marital status, educational attainment, and employment status with active transportation. However, we found no evidence that personality traits are associated with active transportation. So in conclusion, our research demonstrates that different health promotion activities appear to be needed for Malaysians of different socio-demographic backgrounds. The information could be used to help identify risk groups for inactivity and inactive transportation promotion work. The findings from this study support the need of interventions to promote active transportation among the Malaysian population. However, we will conduct further analysis using a larger sample to confirm these initial results. Thank you very much for listening.